Welcome to the First United Methodist Church of Shelbyville, Tennessee, the Church on the Square. Though physically separated from one another, we are still bound together as a family of faith, which opens our arms and our hearts to extend God's love to all. As members of the household of God, we now join together virtually, yet still present with one another as we gather from across the mountains. This presence is marked by our shared experience of praise and prayers, our shared hearing and affirming God's word, and now our sharing in Holy Communion. We hope you have prepared for this service by having the elements of communion, bread or crackers, and juice available for all who will be worshiping with you tonight. We want to be mindful of our prayer praises and concerns, and I know our hearts are full of praise and thanksgiving for the musical offering of John Rock and Lori Schuler this evening, and we're grateful to Ashley Porter for taking care of our live stream videoing. Let us remember Ted Phillips, who will be heading to Vanderbilt tomorrow morning to have a pacemaker installed. Let us also continue to keep Virginia Ray in our prayers as she is still under hospice care at NHC Rutherford, and there with her daughters, Doris Walden and Debbie Thomas, by her side. Let us also lift up Christy Gozov, who is the sister of Cassie Davis. She did not get the results she was hoping for yesterday from a recent scan of her lungs and liver. We continue in prayer for Sissy Owen, sister Randy Owen, who is still on the ventilator at the Summit Medical Center. William Dean had hip surgery today, hip replacement, at the Williamson Medical Center in Franklin, Tennessee, and is still there recuperating. Andy Borders had a procedure this past Monday to remove a kidney stone, and all went well with that procedure, but we do want to continue to pray for his healing and pray for all others whose names have gone unmentioned tonight. I'd like to share with you the gospel reading that we had this past Sunday and invite you to hear it again as you open your heart to hear God's word. Jesus says, "But what shall I compare this generation? It's like children who were sitting in the marketplace and calling out to one another, 'We played the flute for you, and you did not dance. We wailed, and you did not mourn.' For you see, John came neither eating nor drinking, and they said, 'He is a demon.' And the Son of Man came eating and drinking, and they said, 'Well, look, a glutton, a drunkard, a friend of tax collectors and servants.' Yet wisdom is vindicated by her deeds. Come to me, all you that are here heavy weight, or weary and heavy laden, those of you who are carrying heavy burdens, come to me, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am gentle and humble in heart, and you will find rest for your souls. For my yoke is easy and my burden is light." Life and stress, they go hand in hand. We will experience lots and lots of stress in our lives. There's just so many around us. And I believe that the degree to which we effectively manage and cope with the stress in our lives will determine the degree to which we are healthy and whole. If we turn to unhealthy behaviors to cope with all of this stress in our lives, our physical, emotional, and spiritual health will suffer. But long ago, Jesus told his followers, and through the miracle of God's presence today, he still says to us, "Come to me. Come to me, all of you who are weary and carry heavy burdens, and I'll give you rest. Take my yoke upon you. Let me teach you, because I am humble and gentle, and you will find much rest for your souls. For my yoke will fit you perfectly, and the burden that drugs, not food, not alcohol, not even the internet. And that's why God inspired Matthew to capture the wisdom of Jesus found in this short teaching on this topic, in this wonderful invitation, come to me. But how do we come to Jesus? We pray. We listen to inspirational music like Laurie and John shared with us earlier. We sit down and breathe deeply and maybe walk quietly and listen for his voice. We cry out to God in desperation. We read God's word, the Bible. We sometimes have to just get on our knees and pour out our hearts to him. And we come to this table. And when we do this, Jesus promises that God will give us this very best we sorely need. Hear this invitation. Christ our Lord invites to his table all who love him, who earnestly repent of their sin, and who seek to live in peace with one another. Therefore, let us confess our sin before God and one another.
Merciful God, we confess that we have not loved you with our whole heart. We have failed to be an obedient church. We have not done your will. We have broken your law. We have rebelled against your love. We have not loved our neighbors, and we have not heard the cry of the needy. Forgive us, we pray. Free us for joyful obedience through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Hear the good news. Christ died for us while we were yet sinners, and that proves God's love toward us. In the name of Jesus Christ, you are forgiven.
In the name of Jesus Christ, you are forgiven.
Glory
to God. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
Blessed are you, our Alpha and Omega, whose strong, loving arms encompass the whole universe. For with your eternal word and Holy Spirit, you are forever one God. Through your word, you created all things, and you called them good. And in you we live and move and have our being. When we fell into sin, you did not desert us. You made covenant with your people, Israel, and you spoke to the prophets and the teachers. And in Jesus Christ, you even became flesh and dwelt among us, full of grace and truth. And so with your people on earth and all the company of heaven, we praise your name and join their unending hymn, Holy,
Holy, Holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
Holy are you. And blessed is your Son, Jesus Christ, who called you Abba, Father. As a mother tenderly gathers her children, you embrace a people as your own, and you fill them with a longing for a peace that would last, and for a justice that would never fail. In Jesus' suffering and death, you took upon yourself our sin and our death, and you destroyed their power forever. You raised up from the dead this very same Jesus, who now reigns with you in glory, and you pour out upon us your Holy Spirit, making us the people of your new covenant. On the night before meeting with his death, Jesus took bread and he gave thanks to you. He broke the bread and he gave it to his disciples and said, "Take, eat. This is my body, which So, in remembrance of these, your mighty acts in Jesus Christ, we now offer ourselves in praise and thanksgiving as a holy and living sacrifice in union with Christ's offering for us as we proclaim the mystery of faith.
Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again.
Pour out your Holy Spirit on all of us gathered here and wherever we may be in this time of worship. And on these gifts for your Holy Spirit, that in the breaking of this bread and the drinking of this wine, we may know the presence of the living Christ, and we may be renewed as the body of Christ for the world, redeemed by Christ's blood. As the grain and the grapes once dispersed in the fields are now united on this table in bread and wine, so may we and all your people be gathered from every kind and place into the unity of the eternal household and feast at your table forever. Through Christ, with Christ, in Christ, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, glory is yours, Almighty God, now and forever. Amen. Now let us pray as our Lord Jesus Christ gave us the confidence in praying and saying,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
The body of Christ, the bread of heaven, the blood of Christ, the cup of salvation, back to you now to receive these gifts of grace. We bless you, O God, for the gifts of bread and cup, for